folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on listing buckets on MinIO with Java. And in this video, we're using OpenJDK 19 and Maven 4, as well as play.min.io, our online sandbox, and we're going to be running all of this out of VS Code. Just briefly, we're going to be taking a look at the list buckets method out of our Java API, and I'm also going to talk a little bit about how you can work with the buckets that you get back. So let's go ahead and take a look at some code. All right, here I've got a little Mavenized build that is going to build this simple app class, and then I'm actually going to be calling out of the main method this demo function. Now, the main method in this case is really just setting up a connection to play.min.io, very simple to do, and it is also going to handle any exceptions for me so that my demo method can really just focus on the code that I want to take a look at here for this demo. And for this demo, the code that we're looking at is list buckets right here on line 29. Now, the list buckets method takes an argument should it need one, and that argument can include some headers or it can include a query. But in most cases, what you're going to be doing is you're just going to want to list out this whole list of buckets just to see what buckets you have available out there. And some of the errors that you might get out of this, you may get an exception if your authentication isn't working or if you don't have permissions to actually do the task. All of that comes out in the form of a MinIO exception, which again, I'm catching in my main method. But once you get this list back, it is legitimately a Java list like any other Java list you may have been working with. The difference is that we've got bucket objects, and bucket objects are actually from MinIO. And what I've done here is I've made a for list for each bucket that is found in the bucket list. I'm going to print out the name and I'm going to print out the creation date. Now it turns out that the buckets themselves, if we take a look at the interface for the bucket, there's not really much else that I can do with this. All of these other ones are really largely from the object inheritance that we get. I can do a creation date and I can do a name, but that is really everything that I can get out of my bucket object that I care about. So that is very simple to use. Very straightforward. I get a name, I get a creation date, and that's all I'm going to do. I'm just going to print them out. So let's go ahead and save this, and we'll go ahead and do a build mvn clean package. And I'm actually building an executable jar file out of this. And so when I run this, I'm going to do a Java jar, and I'm going to go ahead and call target demo 1.0 jar. And when I run this, there we go. We get a few buckets back out. Some folks have created some buckets out on our play.min.io. If you were to run something similar, if you were to do your own list buckets against play.min.io, you'd probably see a different list because this list is changing all the time. Again, our play.min.io sandbox, anybody can attach to it. Anybody can create their own bucket, upload their own objects. The thing is that data gets collected every once in a while. So you may not always see the same buckets that I'm seeing here. And with that, that is our demo on the list buckets call for the MinIO client out of Java. I hope you've enjoyed this demo. If you'd like to reach out to us, you can connect to us with any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also work with us interactively on minio.slack.com, or you can just leave a comment here on this video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.